students. So previous class we came to know about the reproduction of plants from seeds, and today we shall see about the dispersal of seeds. Dispersal, students, dispersal mean scattering, splitting. Okay, so dispersal means scattering. So dispersal means scattering or splitting. Students, now what is the dispersal of seeds? So we know there are so many kinds of trees and plants in the whole world, right? But we are not planting them. Then how are the plants and the trees growing on their own? Who sowed the seeds of those plants? We human beings are not going and we are not sowing those seeds, right? Then who is doing all this? Yes, all the seeds. So then they will be sown naturally by the nature. Now, how, in which process, in what ways the nature helps the plant in sowing their seeds? Let us see. So these seeds, they can disperse. So disperse means they will scatter. Scatter means spreading all around. Okay, they will spread or they will scatter by wind. They can, next, they can dispersal by water. The dispersal can take place by animal also, by wind, by water, by animal, and even by the explosions. Now the question is, why seeds need to be dispersed? Why they need to get scattered? Because if all the seeds of a plant, you know, there will be so many seeds in a particular plant, and if all those seeds will be sown at one place, what will happen? So the plants will not grow healthily and hence the plant will die. Why? Because the seeds will not get enough space for each other, the seeds will not get enough water, the seeds will not get enough air, and the seeds will not get enough minerals to grow. And hence, finally, the seed, they will be immature while developing, and hence they will die. And there will be no more growth of plants or trees. And hence, there must be a need of dispersal of the seeds. For example, if you get 10 to 15 seeds, and if you sow all those 10 to 15 seeds in a single pot, so what will happen? All the seeds will never grow only. Why? Because 10 to 15 seeds can't grow in a single pot. Why? Because they can't get enough soil, and in which there will be no enough minerals, no enough water, mainly no enough space to grow. Hence, there must be a scattering process for the seeds to grow the healthy and many more plants. And these are the ways through which the seeds are dispersed all over the world with the help of nature. So nature means naturally they will spread. So they will spread through wind. Wind is nothing but the strong air. Okay, they can spread through wind, they can spread by water, they can spread by animals. So seeds can also be scattered or spread by explosion. Now let us have a look about these processes.
Dispersal of seeds. Plants need adequate space to grow properly. If all of them grow under the parent plant and do not get enough space, many of them will die in these conditions. When they will not get enough water, mineral salts or sunlight required for them grow, they will fight against each other for their needs and the weaker ones will die. That is why seeds need to be scattered away from the parent plants. This process of scattering or spreading of seeds to different places is known as dispersal of seeds. Dispersal of seeds happen in four ways: through water, wind, animals, and explosion of the fruit. These are known as agents of dispersal. Scattering by wind. Some seeds have long and fine hair on them. Seeds like maple, dandelion, drumstick, madar, and hiptage have wings or tufts of hair on them. These hair or wings help them to float in the wind. Scattering by water. Some plants like lotus and coconut grow in or near water. The fruits and seeds of these plants are easily dispersed by flowing water. The coconut has a thick coverage of fiber and lotus plant has a spongy part that help them to float. So, the seeds reach far away from their parent plants. Scattering by animals. Humans and animals eat fruits that contain seeds. We throw away the seeds after eating fruits like mangoes, oranges, apples, cherries, and plums. The small hard seeds of guava, etc., are thrown out of our bodies with the waste. All such seeds are carried far away from the parent plants. Seeds of many plants have stiff hair, hooks, or spines. These seeds stick to our clothes and the fur or skin of animals and are carried far away by these animals. Scattering by explosion of fruit. Some fruits like pea, balsam, geranium, and touch-me-not plants explode on drying. Their seeds are thrown out and scattered away from the parent plants. Know this, there are nearly 380,000 different kinds of plants on the earth. They are found everywhere except places which are completely dark and dry.
So students, now you got to know how the dispersal of seeds happen. That means how seeds get scattered and those scattered seeds get converted into the plants and trees. So till this, we had discussed about the reproduction of plants from seeds. And now we will discuss the reproduction in plants from the body parts. Okay, and this plants with the help of the body parts, plants can be grown through underground stems, roots, leaves, and through the stem cuttings. So the stems, roots, leaves, all these are the parts of a plant, isn't it? And hence, how can these be grown? So some plants grow from the underground stems, some plants grow from roots, some plants can be grown through their leaves, and some plants grow from the stem cuttings. So how through the body parts of a plant can be grown, and what are the examples of such kind of plants for these processes? Let us have a look at this videogram.
Reproduction in plants. Plants also reproduce to ensure the continuation of the species. They reproduce in many ways. Most of the plants grow from their seeds. There are some plants that reproduce from different parts like the roots, stems, or leaves. These plants are able to grow without seeds. The process by which the different parts of a plant grow into a new plant is called vegetative reproduction. Reproduction through stems. Have you observed a potato carefully? It has some small black dots on it called eyes. When an eye, also called bud, is planted, it grows into a new plant. Several plants like ginger and potato are actually underground stems. These stems store food in them and grow into new plants through their buds. Each bud grows as a new plant. Some new plants can also grow from pieces of the stem because they have buds on them. These pieces of stem are called stem cuttings. Many plants like sugarcane, rose, hibiscus, etc. grow from stem cuttings. Activity. Take a big potato. Cut it into several parts in such a way that each part of it has a bud. Plant these potato parts in moist soil. These potato parts will grow into new potato plants. Reproduction from leaves. Some plants like the bryophyllum have fleshy and thick leaves bearing buds on its edges. These buds on the edges of the leaves grow as new plants. When leaves fall down on the ground, the buds start growing. Activity: pluck a bryophyllum leaf and place it in between the pages of a book. If you see it after 2 to 3 days, you will find several new plants growing from the buds all along the edges. Reproduction from roots. The roots of plants like sweet potato grow as new plants. Activity: take a sweet potato and support it in a bottle containing water using toothpicks. You will find that after a few days, a new plant grows in the bottle.
So students, that's about the reproduction in plants from the seeds and from the body parts. So today we shall end up our class here, and in the next class we shall go for the further content. Thank you.